My name is Gianpaolo Merlini, and I am from the Pavia Amyloidosis Research and Treatment Center. I would like to update you on the last advances in rare amyloidosis. And this year has been really extraordinary because three main studies have been completed and reported. So the first one in chronological order is a study comparing melphalan and dexamethasone versus melphalan and dexamethasone and bortezomib. The addition of this proteasome inhibitor was translated into improved response rate significantly, and the overall response rate was close to 80%, and that translated into improved progression-free survival and overall survival. This study was an independent study that was coordinated by the European Myeloma Network, including several academic centers in Europe. The second study has been completed, that is the Tourmaline AL amyloidosis study, comparing isadomide dexamethasone versus physician choice. Although this study was an international phase 3 study, and although it did not reach the primary endpoint, that was overall response rate, that was similar between the two groups, patients treated with isadomide dexamethasone had a more profound and more durable responses that translated into improved cardiac and renal responses and duration of the organ responses. So we believe that this combination is very effective in patients with relapsed or refractory AL amyloidosis. The study was done in this patient population. The first study is the Andromeda study performed in upfront therapy, as an upfront therapy in patients with AL amyloidosis, comparing CyBorD versus CyBorD plus daratumumab. The addition of the monoclonal antibody had an important impact on the outcome of this patient. The complete response rate was significantly improved, up to more than 50%, reaching an overall response rate of more than 90%. This translated also in a significantly improved cardiac and renal responses. The depth and the speed of these responses, we believe, has been a really breakthrough in the care of AL amyloidosis. And this regimen is becoming the new standard of care for upfront patients with AL amyloidosis. So we have at least three important studies that really contributed greatly to improve the care of this disease. There are also now studies ongoing in order to improve our capability to measure the response to therapy. Due to these advances, now we see more and more patients achieving a complete response. And we are studying the way to improve our capability to measure the best possible response to therapy. And this is also true for the organ response, thanks to the work done by our colleague at Mayo, who are studying a way to grade the organ response in order to improve, again, our care of the patient and modulate the treatment accordingly. So overall for ALL, amyloidosis patient has been an extraordinary year with new drugs, and I believe that this will greatly improve overall the care of these conditions, also because we will have also new tools to measure the responses, thus improving also the design of trials for future drugs.